Munson and I here, we're a happily married couple, but there's a kink in our marriage. And what could that be?
Large testicles.
Oh! To some that might be a good thing, but to others, they can't be. So we're going to do a scene about his large testicles. And from time to time, we're going to come into this bowl and read some of the lines that you guys had written out in the hallway. And we're going to incorporate that into our scene. And this is called Cliffhangers.
Oh, Susan, this is getting painful. More and more so by the day.
Oh, George, I'm so sorry for you. That just, it just looks like it stretches.
Man, we shouldn't have tried that ring you ordered, that rubber ring from the magazine. I can't get it off, and I'm too embarrassed to go to the emergency room.
Oh, George, we gotta use this little wheelie dolly
I did some research on the internet. They said you get a compact ice. Right?
Yeah.
You get a compact thing of ice and you put it on there to bring the swelling down. And then the next thing it said to do was...
Georgie.
You deserve an award for that.
Oh, you do!
Because you know, the statistics show that 1 out of 972 men have elephant testiculitis.
Oh, George, you do need an award because there's not too many men who could deal with this problem like this for the 3 weeks that you have been dealing with.
It is bad. You know, honey, I have to say, you have been with me through thick and thin.
Well, you know, I just keep in mind what the minister said to us the day he wedded us, and the last thing that he said, you know, besides the sickness and the health and all that, he also said at the end, she said she wanted a round of applause, so I gave her the clap. That's right. Oh, he knew.
He knew something like this was going to happen.
That's true. He gave me the clap because he knew you would have a problem.
Pastor Bob has really been our inspiration, and he seems to be very intuitive, but I can tell you all the intuition in the world just doesn't make me feel any better right now.
You know, I think I should call him because I think right about now we could use some divine intervention.
But look, honey, don't have him come over. This is embarrassing.
No, I'll just call him on the phone.
What do you think he'll say?
I have a pretty good idea. It's baby seal time.
No!
He's going to think that's a baby seal.
I'm not going to balance my balls on the baby seal's nose. It ain't going to do nothing.
It kind of looks like a, you know, baby seal in the little hairs. But you know, we really should go to the doctor because it has been getting larger and larger as each week.
It is getting more painful, but look, I read the damn insurance policy the other day, and line 13-14 said if you've got a problem, anything below the belt.
Yes?
This is the suggestion they gave us. Queens never eat popcorn.
No,
never!
They don't! Oh!
And this is the problem! This is the problem, honey. You can't keep feeding me that popcorn from Britain.
No, you're right.
It expands in my stomach and clearly it's going to other places.
The salt is making you swell.
It is. You gotta do something faster. We gotta, you know what? I'm just about ready to put a rubber band around it and just let it go.
You know, I'm gonna look at the internet and see what it says when I type
up. Hold it! Look at that!
That's what it says.
I don't got glasses. You read it for me.
I'm pregnant.